sort of like, fake rapping at each other's face. Our next performer, you know, I don't know, this is what, like your second or third time here, right? Second time. Yeah, that's right. Let's welcome John Elliott onto the stage. Yes? Let's welcome John.
Hey, I'm going to take my cue from Juan and sit down. It's comfortable. So I had some more stuff about babies and work, which is my favorite Talking Heads album, but I think I'm not going to do that because I saw a commercial that really pissed me off, and I don't know if it's unprofessional, but I wrote it down because I don't want this shit etched chemically into my brain. This was a Subway commercial for the new pastrami sandwich, and I'll try to read it in the douchey announcer voice they use as best I can, and I'm not making any of this up. This is the actual text of the commercial. And I, by the way, I don't know what is the thought process with this voiceover guy. Like, does Subway, they're in negotiations with the advertising firm, and Subway's like, you know, can we get somebody who sounds like a total dickhead and yet will frighten small children? And Subway's like, oh yeah, we got Eddie, he does monster truck stuff. Oh, perfect. That's exactly what we're going for. All right, so here's the text of the commercial. Rocking out to the big hot pastrami. Which, that's not too egregious as far as commercials go, I guess. It's fairly stupid, but really, if your idea of rocking out is eating a pastrami sandwich, you should probably add some diapers to your grocery list next time. In fact, if you're just eating at Subway in general, you should probably add diapers to your grocery list. But all right, now here's where it gets bizarre. Don't dare call it a cover band. Oh, thanks, Duffman. I think if we learn anything from Gandhi and Martin Luther King, it's that the best way to persuade someone of your message is to threaten them. Listen up, pussies. Don't even dream about fucking with this sandwich, because it will rain down a shitstorm of agony and despair all over your stupid face, and it will wreck your credit rating. So I don't dare call it a cover band. Well, I wouldn't dare, Subway man, because I haven't taken acid since 85. And it was some good Owsley shit, too. I might have... Yeah. All right. Acid, drugs, man. Thanks. I guess this is not a monologue anymore. I don't even understand what they're trying to say there. Don't call it... Like I would unwrap it and then think, shit. Is this a pastrami sandwich or a cover band? Because I don't hear it playing a shitty version of How Soon Is Now, but it's probably best to err on the side of caution. I don't want to eat it if it's a cover band. That might fuck shit up. No fucking sense. Don't dare call it a cover band. Sorry, let me get to the next line, which is... Unless you're talking about covering freshly baked bread with layer upon layer of flavor-packed pastrami. Well, of course, that's what I'm talking about. When I tell somebody I just saw a cover band, they're like, oh, whose song did they play? I'm like, no, it was all originals. They just came out wrapped in giant pieces of bread. This sub lays down power chords of tastosity with pickles, mean licks of mustard, and riffs of melty, bubbly cheese. Does it really lay down mean riffs, Steve Miller? Thanks. You know, if anybody said mean licks to me, I would first of all say thanks for 8 years of Reagan and eating up Social Security. And then I would yank their fucking filthy hippie ponytail right out of their head. It ends with, catch them before the
Fresh toasted tour leaves town. Subway, big hot pastrami. Crank up the flavor, Subway! So I wish I would have caught who that commercial was actually for. They should probably mention that in their thing. Am I running out of time, Raj?
Yeah, you've got like a little less than
a minute. Okay, I'll go into some other stuff then. So I am middle-aged, which is which is more wishful thinking than accurate description, because unless there's some miraculous advances in medicine, I'm not going to make it to 80. But your whole sensibilities change when you get older. Like, hemorrhoids are funny, right? Until you hit 40, and then they're just another thing to cross off your bucket list. And then you can't even... You know, like, I get embarrassed calling up the doctor when I have embarrassing shit and I have to tell, like, the advice nurse what's wrong, and I'm like, oh, it's my anus. I don't know. My anus is all veiny now. Like, I can't do that. So I, like, make up shit. Like, my neck hurts. And I go in, and then I'll go in, and the doctor will be like, well, your neck seems fine. I don't see anything wrong with it. I'm like, oh, okay, well, by the way, should my semen be black? Is that time? All right, that's it for me. Thanks.